morning po sa lahat ng mga kadete na nagre-review online sa Luzon, Visayas at sa Mindanao. Sa mga kadete natin na under, estudyante pa lang, but under the subject Law Enforcement Organization and Administration. Sa mga instructors natin sa Criminology, part-time tsaka yung regular, pati na yung mga review lecturers right now who are preparing the respective reviewees for the upcoming CLA. Magandang umaga po sa inyo. Welcome! Welcome po sa second episode ng discussion natin. In the first episode, I talked to you about the history of the law enforcement, pati na yung preliminary topics ng Philippine National Police. Again, remember po, sa mga nag-o-online lang dyan para sa review for the upcoming CLA, ibig sabihin ng law enforcement pillar, ito po ang pillar na nag-enforce ng batas natin. Pero ang law enforcement pillar does not only consist the Philippine National Police. Marami pa pong ahensya sa gobyerno na considered as law enforcement agency. Kasali na po dyan ang PNP. Marami pa po, aside from PNP, we have NBI and other law enforcement agencies. But we will be discussing on the other law enforcement agencies on the later topics na. Right now, concentrate muna tayo sa highlight natin, yung Philippine National Police. Okay? Now, in the first episode, I talk about line, staff, and auxiliary functions. At the same time, I talk about the nature of office of the Philippine National Police. Now, right now, we will start the discussion by taking a look on the organizational structure ng PNP. Ano po ba ang organizational structure? Now, unahin po natin yung chief of the PNP or the chief of the Philippine National Police. Ang chief of the PNP is considered as the head of the Philippine National Police. Okay? Head of the Philippine National Police. Ang chief PNP, kailanganin po na ang rank ko niya is police general. Okay? Police general ha? Ang second in command sa chief of the Philippine National Police, itong deputy chief for administration. Second in command ha? So pag wala yung chief PNP, yung deputy chief for administration will take over. Ang rangko naman niya, according to the law, should be at least police lieutenant general. Okay? Police lieutenant general. Pag wala yung chief, wala yung admin, ang third in command will be the deputy chief for operations. Ano ba ang rangko ng chief of the deputy chief for operations? Same rank with the deputy chief for administration, police lieutenant general pa rin. Okay? Now, in the national office, may tinatawag po tayong chief of directorial staff. Okay? Sa national office, may chief of directorial staff. Siya po ang tinatawag na head of the directorial staff. Ang rangko niya po, same pa rin, police lieutenant general. Now, on the other hand, let us not confuse ourselves kasi yung staff po kasi consists of various divisions. Okay? Yung pinaka-head niya, yung pinaka-head shall be known as the chief of the directorial staff. Chief of the directorial staff. Pero, ang mga staff po, may mga divisions po yan. Ang head on a particular staff division shall be known as the director of the directorial staff. Okay? The director of the directorial staff. But remember na ang director of the directorial staff, ang rangko dapat niya should be Major General. Ano po ba ang title niya? Director of the directorial staff. I repeat. Di ba ang sa pinakataas is yung chief of the directorial staff, right? In the national level. Chief of the directorial staff, yung pinaka-head. Okay, yung pinaka-head. Now, ang sabi ko, ang staff po consist of various divisions po yan. In a particular division or bawat division, may director po, may head. Okay? Ang head sa division na yan shall be having the title known as Director of the directorial staff. Ang tanong ngayon, sir, sino ba ang mataas, yung director of the directorial staff or yung chief of the directorial staff? Of course, yung pinakamataas sa kanila would be the chief of the directorial staff. Okay? I hope that is very clear. Now again, ang rangko po niya is dapat major general. Next, the heads of the administrative and operational support divisions, dapat ang rangko niya is police, brigadier, general. So take note of the different ranks po ha in every position in the Philippine National Police. Now, punta naman tayo sa mga heads in national or in the regional, pati na yung sa municipal at city. Sa National Capital Region, okay? Sa National Capital Region, NCR, dapat po ang rangko is Police Major General. Siya po ang magiging tinatawag nating NCR Director. Ano po ba ang rangko? Police Major General. Pangalawa, yung sa region, yung Regional Director o tinatawag nating RD. Yung Regional Director po, dapat ang rangko niya is Police Brigadier General. Police Brigadier General. Now, ang mga district offices naman sa National Capital Region, ang rangko niya, same pa rin sa regional office, Police Brigadier General pa rin, pero ang title niya magiging District Director. Kung sa district office po yan ng National Capital Region. On the other hand, the heads of the district offices must have the rank Police Lieutenant Colonel, tapos ang position niya shall be District Director pag outside NCR po ha, pag outside NCR. Ang sabi ko kanina, pag inside sa NCR po, yung district office, ang rangko niya is Police Brigadier General, tapos ang title niya is District Director. Pero ang District Director outside NCR, ang rangko niya hindi po Brigadier General, but only Lieutenant Colonel. I hope, klarong-klaro po yan ha. Klarong-klaro yan pagka-discuss na yan. Next, sa PD naman, Provincial Director, ang rangko dapat niya is Police Colonel. Okay? Police Colonel po ang rangko pag Provincial Director. Pag sa munisipyo, it's either Municipal Police Station or City Police Station, ang chief dapat should have the rank of Police Major. Ano po ba ang required na rank? Police Major para magiging chief siya sa municipality or city. Kaya nga po, pag ang, especially in Negros Oriental right now, pag ang particular person who becomes the head of the city or municipal station, pag hindi po nakaabot sa Police Major, usually ang title po sa position niya is OIC lang po, Officer in Charge. Okay, Officer in Charge. But the chief, again, huwag natin kalimutan, should have the rank of Police Major. Now, ang Philippine National Police, again, cadets, I hope this will not be boring, pero ganito po talaga ang structure natin. Now, ang Philippine National Police, may mga staff. As I have stated a while ago, may mga staff po yan. Okay? May mga staff in every division, ang head po tinatawag na director of the directorial staff. Ito po yung mga directorial staff natin, okay? Number one, if it talks about the utilization of personnel, both from the uniform and non-uniform personnel, sir. May mga non-uniform personnel pala sa PNP? The answer is yes. Okay? Ang tawag po sa kanila is NUP or non-uniform police. Usually, they are assigned to do admin task. For example, yung crime registrar natin, NUP yan. Sometimes, the fingerprint examiner is also an NUP. So, ang deployment thereof or ang pag-utilize sa kanila, both yung uniform tsaka yung non-uniform personnel, under po yan sa Directorate for Personnel and Record Management. Pag it talks about intelligence information, ano po bang ibig sabihin ng intelligence? The result of the collection, evaluation, analysis of raw information in order to arrive on a timely decision making. So ang intelligence information, Ang pag-collate po dyan, ang pag-gather po dyan should be within the Directorate for Intelligence. Now, on the other hand, lahat ng PNP operations, okay, lahat ng PNP operations including the command, the control, the direction, the coordination, under po siya sa tinatawag nating Directorate for Operations. Next, logistics on the other hand. Ano po ba ang mga logistics? Yung binibili natin, yung na-purchase natin. It talks about the equipment. Both in the payment or in the business transaction thereof, yung pagbili, yung pag perhaps disposal of it, or yung pag-utilize thereof, under po siya sa Directorate for Logistics. For example, bumili ka ng helicopter para sa Philippine National Police for helicopter patrol. Diba? Mag-helicopter patrol ka. So, bumili ng helicopter. Under po siya sa logistics. On the other hand, yung plans naman and programs in the Philippine National Police, pati na yung pag-present or representation or representative sa international tsaka interagency affairs on peace and order, kasali po yan sa responsibility ng Directorate for Plans. Next, controllership. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng controllership? If it will come out in the board exam, ang word po na ito, it means money. Okay? It means finances. Basta you heard the word or you see the word or you read the word, controllership, wala pong ibang ibig sabihin dyan, money. So, ang utilization ng pera, yung finances sa Philippine National Police, under po siya sa Directorate for Controllership. Next, if it talks about the establishment of a good relationship with the activities, doing community-related activities, projects, and programs, under po sa Directorate for Police Community Relation. On the other hand, if it talks about investigation, okay? Investigation activities, under po siya sa Directorate for Investigation and Detective Management. Actually, cadets, these are very easy to understand. Pag itong mga functions na to lalabas sa board examination, you can actually spot out the correct answer, di ba? Kasi andyan yung keyword eh. Andyan yung keyword. So, pag nakalagay dyan, directorial staff in charge of investigation, yung answer mo is investigation and detective management. Kasi nandyan yung keyword. Anyway, but we have to discuss this, right? We have to discuss this because basically this is part of the contents. Next, Directorate for Human Resources and Doctrine Development. This is the office or the staff which formulate policies on matters pertaining to human resources or doctrine development. So, for example, yung pag-hire natin sa mga patrolman or the first rank, under po siya sa Human Resources and Doctrine Development. Sa research naman, itong Directorate for Research and Development. On the other hand, if it talks about technology, technological advancement sa PNP, wala na pong iba. Ang staff po dyan is the Directorate for Information and Communication Technology Management or DICTM. Okay? On the other hand, may tinatawag tayong DPOS. Okay? Ano po ba itong DPOS? The Directorate for Integrated Police Operations. From the word integrated, pinag-isa po yan. Pinag-isa. The responsibility is to direct and to supervise the conduct of integrated anti-criminality, internal security, counter-terrorism, operations to promote interoperability with the armed forces of the Philippines. Diba? Usually, yung Philippine National Police, yung SAF natin, may dual operation po, cooperation with the armed forces of the Philippines. So, yung contribution po, yung pag-establish ng relationship and to supervise the operations involving the armed forces of the Philippines to combat its either insurgency or counterterrorism, part po sa responsibility yan ng integrated police operations. Yung director po sa IPO or integrated police operation na yan. Next, national support units. Ano ba tong national support units? Isa lang po ang ibig sabihin ng NSU. Pag in-issue po, ito po yung police personnel assigned on an exclusive, in an exclusive nature of a job. Okay? For example, pag maritime law, yung exclusivity, maritime law, ang responsable po dyan is yung maritime group. Remember po sa Magcardo Dalisay dyan, pag mag-a-apply kayo, I know you will pass the board examination in God's, you know, in God's grace, nakapasa tayo. Pag in-issue po ang recruitment or National Support Unit po, ang recruitment, ibig sabihin dyan, the moment you are hired, you will be assigned in a certain unit where you are classified to be assigned in. For example, if the human resource department of the PNP will classify you and put you in the maritime group, dyan ka po, ang nature of office mo will be the protection, the development, the security, the sustainability of maritime environment. So particularly about the fishery law, maritime laws, yan po ang i-enforce mo pag naka-assign ka sa maritime group. On the other hand, pag intelligence group ka po na-assign, so basically you'll be responsible in the collation, the gathering or evaluation of intelligence information. On the other hand, may tinatawag din tayong security and protection group. Ano pa tong PSPG? Ang security and protection group, for example, may mga vital individuals or for example yung presidente ng America will visit Philippines or other notable persons from other countries, sila po ang maka-assign for the safety and security of that person. Okay? Yan po ang trabaho nila. So hindi po pwedeng naka-assign ka sa maritime group and on the other day you will go to the other way around to guard a particular personnel unless you are augmented. Pero in usual manner, pag maritime group ka, ang trabaho mo is on the maritime matters. Okay? Pag intelligence group ka naka-assign, your job is will be on the intelligence matters. Next, aside from that, yung CIDG. Okay? CIDG. So, yung investigation, monitoring, prosecution of the crime, as long as yung crime is of such magnitude and extent na ang pag-commit sa kanila is done by the professional criminal syndicates and organizations, pwede po ang CIDG will come in. Or in some instances, pag yung crime is heinous and it attracts the attention of the community, pwede po that such crime will be turned over to the CIDG. Okay? Next, yung SAF. Remember po ha, yung Special Action Force, considered po yung the elite force of the Philippine National Police. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng elite? Ibig sabihin ng elite yung pinaka-high caliber. Pinaka-high caliber sa Philippine National Police in terms of counter-terrorism, counter-insurgency, and similar operations. Ang SAF is also known as a mobile strike force or a reaction unit. Next, kung gusto mong ma-assign sa airport, airport ka, magiging airport police, you can actually apply also and you can be under the aviation security group because you provide security to all airports throughout the country. Napaka-easy po yung job mo. Andyan ka lang sa airport and of course providing security in that area. Next, pag enforcement of Republic Act 4136. Ano ba to Republic Act 4136? Diba tinatawag yung Land Transportation Code of the Philippines? Diba? Cadets, yung nagre-review right now, traffic management subject, Republic Act 4136, the Land Transportation Code of the Philippines. Pati na yung mandatory helmet law, anything that relates about land transportation. Sino po ba ang may responsibilidad dyan? Yung HPG, Highway Patrol Group. Pero, I have to make myself very clear. Pwede po, kahit regular quota ka, naging patrolman ka, pwede po that the regional office might put you or might shift you from ordinary policing task into National Support Unit. Pwede po, naka-assign ka on, maybe on patrol lang, pero yung region will command or will order you to you know, to be put on HPG or whatever units in the Philippine National Police. Pwede po yan, ha? So HPG again on transportation. On the other hand, if it talks about relation with the community, police community relation group, pwede din po sa civil security group. Now, I will explain on the civil security group. Sa civil security group, may dalawa po siyang branches. Yung FEO, tsaka yung SOSIA. Okay? Yung SOSIA is O-S-I-A. Ha? Yung SOSIA is a branch of the CSG that will give permits or will give certificates or will give licensing, whatever necessary documentary requirements para po sa operation ng watchman agency or security agency or even on the private detective agency. So lahat po ng mga security guards po, I think that's Republic Act 5487, under po sa CSG, particular CSG SOSIA. Ang pangalawang branch niya po is yung FEO. FEO stands for Firearms and Explosives Office. Pag CSG FEO yan, ang responsibility niya po is on the licensing and the permit licensing registration of firearms. For example, permit to carry of firearms, ILTAP, license to own and operate firearms. Lahat ng mga ito, as long as it talks about Republic Act 10591, yung sa bagong batas natin sa firearms, pwede po sa CSG FEO. Dalawa ha, SOSIA tsaka yung FEO. Next, if it talks about scientific examination of evidences or pieces of evidence that are recovered from the crime scene, sino po ba ang mag-analyze dyan? Ang crime laboratory. If it talks about kidnapping, sino ba ang responsibilidad? Ang PNP Anti-Kidnapping Group. Pag about computers, cybercrime, for example, money laundering or identity theft, e-libel. Lahat ng mga ito, crimes that are perpetuated by a network or an internet or by a computer system, Anti-Cybercrime Group may kami. Sa grupo po na ito, sa unit na ito, dapat po, ang suggestion ko, dapat yung mga IT tsaka yung CCS or Computer Studies or Information Technology, lahat ng mga kurso that has background on computer should be employed in this one. Kasi sila po ang savvy in terms of computer technologies. Okay? Now, let us say, nag-apply tayo. Okay? Tapos nakuha. Granting that you pass all the screening, okay? The process of screening in the PNP. There are actually appointing authority who will appoint you on your particular rank, okay? May mga appointing authority po tayo who can even promote you or they can even appoint you to a particular rank. Sa patrolman patungong Police Executive Master Sergeant. Remember? Patrolman, police staff, police corporal, patungong police executive master sergeant, ang mga rangko po na ito, ang mag-appoint po dyan is yung regional director. Bawat region po, may RD tayo, regional director po. Now, pero, pag ang police na i-appoint, comes from the national headquarters, yung sa Camp Krami, nasa National Headquarters sa Luzon, sa National Capital Region. Ang mag-appoint po, hindi yung RD. Huwag nyo po kalimutan na hindi yung RD, kundi yung Chief of the PNP, yung General. Siya po ang mag-appoint pag National Headquarters yan. However, again, even if it is appointed by the Regional Director or the Chief of the PNP, dapat po ang appointment should be attested by the Civil Service Commission. Dapat po ha, si Atiste, dapat may ano po dyan, may patno ba yan, may go signal yan ng Civil Service Commission. Again, patrolman to Executive Master Sergeant, Commission Officers. Dito naman tayo sa non-commission officers. Dito naman tayo sa Commission Officers. We will start with Police Lieutenant to Police Lieutenant Colonel. Ang appointment po sa rangko na yan will be the Chief of the PNP, but at least there is a recommendation coming from the immediate supervisors, and of course, there must be attestation from the Civil Service Commission. On the other hand, patungo naman sa rangko na Police Colonel to Police Lieutenant General, ang mag-appoint po dyan is no other than the President and the President alone. And the appointment thereof should be with the recommendation of the Chief PNP. Okay? Dapat may recommendation po yan with a proper endorsement also from the Chairman of the Civil Service Commission, and of course, subject for confirmation by the Commission on Appointments. So, dapat po may confirmation as Commission on Appointments. So, okay lang po kung ang chairman sa Commission on Appointments is yung mga mabubuting tao. But sometimes, your credibility will be questioned. Diba? So, yun po ang mga requirements na mga yan sa appointing or sa appointment. Now, lastly, yung pinakataas, yung Police General, di ba? Yung Police General. And of course, the Brigadier General. Pag Police General po, dapat po appointed by the President. Tapos, ang selection thereof will be coming from the rank Police Brigadier General. From among the senior officers down to the rank Police Brigadier General in the service. Subject again, for confirmation by the Commission on Appointments. So, ang gagawin ng Presidente, dapat pumili siya sa Police Brigadier General. Doon siya magpili, tapos, and then, make that person, he selected as the Chief of the PNP. Now, sir, ang tanong, di ba yung panahon ni President Duterte, di ba? During that time, si Senator Bato was the PD, the Provincial Director. So, ano pong nangyari? Bato was promoted to Police Brigadier General, and there he was appointed as the chief of the PNP. So naging Police General po yung rangko niya. Now take note, yung Chief of the PNP, huwag kalimutan ka rin, under Republic Act 551, ang tour of duty niya should not exceed how many years po? Apat lang po ha. Dapat po ang kanyang duty as the chief, dapat apat lang po ang maximum. Pero pwede po yung ma-extend during war lang po. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng during war? For example, nagpatayan itong China at saka yung Pilipinas. Pwede pong ma-extend yung tour of office niya. Pero dapat po ang pag-declare ng war or other national emergency should be within the responsibility or within the shoulder of the Congress. So pag ang Congress po will declare that we are on a national emergency or a state of war, pwede pong ma-extend yung tour of duty ng Chief PNP. Okay, pero pag wala po, pag normal days lang, dapat apat na taon lang po. Now, next is yung police promotion. Ibig sabihin ng promotion, cadets, advancement of a rank. Or, it is a status of change of a policeman amounting to a dynamic elevation of qualified or deserving members to assignment or duties of greater importance. So, ibig sabihin, you will be assigned on functions na mas importante, mas valuable. So, the more you are in a higher rank, the more you have responsibilities that you have to take as a police officer. Now, ang lahat ng promotion po shall be evaluated by the promotion board ng PNP. Unless, of course, exempted by the police general. So, unless exempted ha, sir, ang question, may mga exempted pala sa promotion board? Exempted na for evaluation by the promotion board? Mayroon po tayo. Let's say, for example, yung act of valor, act of bravery. Okay, yung act of bravery, pwede pong that will be exempted by the police general, automatically he will be promoted. Okay? Nakuha niyo po ang exemption na yan. Next, lahat ng promotion shall be based on promotional vacancies. Pag may bakante po, relative seniority standing shall be maintained. Ibig sabihin, when you say relative seniority, ilang taon ka na po ba sa rangko na yan? Okay? So, pag let us say, between two persons, yung isa, 5 years na, yung isa, 2 years pa lang, so dapat yung seniority will be on the police officers having the 5 years experience on that rank. So, siya po ang may priority to be promoted. Next, take note, cadets ha, take note sa lahat ng nagre-review. Pag retirable na po yung police officer, within 12 months or 1 year yan, 12 months of the current promotion, hindi na po siya eligible for regular promotion. For example, promotion season ngayon. Ngayong taon, promotion season. Tapos ikaw na police officer, magre-retire ka na next year. So, hindi ka na po pwedeng ma-promote. Hindi ka na po pwedeng ma-promote kasi you are retirable within 12 months. So, you are basically disqualified. Now, may tatlo po tayong types of promotion. Yung regular, yung special, tsaka yung last one is promotion by virtue of position. Isa-isahin po natin, cadets, ha? Una, regular promotion. Let me read. A quota allocated promotion wherein a candidate must satisfy all the mandatory requirements fixed or for a certain grade. Okay? Now, as you can see on the slide, may mga mandatory requirements po tayo. Ang pinagkaiba ng time in grade tsaka yung seniority in rank is that yung time in grade is yung total period po that a police officer has acquired in a certain grade regardless of status of appointment therein. Pero yung seniority in rank is the total period acquired in a certain grade in permanent status. In permanent status, okay? Yung time and grade is one of the requirements. Pangalawa, yung performance. Ano po ba ang performance? Sum total of candidates' past activities and achievements in a certain work. By the way, guys, yung time and grade po, let us say for example, for patrolman, before siya ma-promote into police corporal, dapat ang time and grade niya po is 4 years. If I'm not mistaken po ha, correct me if I am wrong, but it has to be 4 years before ka ma-promote into police corporal. So, dapat 4 years ka dyan. Sa, whether you are provisionary, regular, or temporary status of appointment, dapat you need to serve 4 years po. So, yan po ibig sabihin to clarify about time and grade. Anyway, potential, the overall gross worth and capability of candidate to assume a higher position and greater responsibility based on tangible past performance, whether you are capable. That's potential training. Dapat nakatapos po tayo yung acquired or prescribed courses for the rank. At the same time, eligibility appropriate for the rank. Ano po ba ang ibig sabihin ng eligibility appropriate for the rank? So, ibig sabihin, ganito po ha. Pag hindi ka po criminologist, tapos hindi ka nakapasa ng board examination, under sa eligibility appropriate for the rank, dapat nakapasa ka ng NAPULCOM promotion examination, promotional examination. Pero pag licensed criminologist ka, eligibility po yan so that, for you to be promoted to police corporal up to lieutenant colonel. So there is no need for you to take any types of eligibility, no need to take the promotion examination ng NAPULCOM kasi may eligibility ka na, may lisensya ka na. Tanong, sir, how about yung licensed professional teacher, yung licensed agriculturist, or yung may lisensya issued by the PRC? Pwede po ba, sir? The answer is yes. Eligibility pa rin yan para they will be promoted. Pareho lang po kayo. Ha? So, between the licensed teacher at yung criminologist na nakapasa ng board, pareho lang po, eligibility po yan para at least ma-promote ka from to police corporal up to lieutenant colonel po. Yan po ang sabi ng batas. Pero, ito ha, Baka sabihin nyo, ay, pwede lang pala magiging education student or agriculture or whatever board course kasi pareho lang pala yung opportunities. Ganito po, in the passage of Republic Act 11131, yan po ang bagong batas natin sa criminology. May section po sa Republic Act 11131, yung tinatawag nating preferential of appointment. Ibig sabihin ng preferential of appointment, if you are a registered criminologist po, you are preferred, you will be prioritized in terms of appointment, in terms of promotion, as compared to non-criminology graduates. So let us just say, for example, dalawa lang yung vacancy natin sa promotion. Let us just say, police corporal lang. Dalawa yung vacancies, tapos tatlo yung nag-apply. Ha? Alam niya, yeah, tatlo yung nag-apply, pero dalawa lang yung vacancies. Yung dalawa dyan, licensed criminologist. Yung isa, licensed professional teacher. Example lang po ito ha, licensed professional teacher. Under the law, yung preference po will go to the licensed criminologist kasi andyan po yan sa Republic Act 11131. So there's a big possibility, pag nakapasa po silang tatlo sa mga screening, there's a big possibility na maiwan yung education graduate kasi ang preference po nasa licensed criminologist. Nakuha nyo po? So pag dalawa or isa lang yung vacancy tapos dalawa ang nag-apply, yung isa criminologist, yung isa hindi, of course yung preference will go to the criminologist kasi may preference tayo po. Yan po ang sabi ng Republic Act 11131. Okay? So yan po ang requirements natin sa tinatawag nating regular promotion. Now, pangalawa, ito, cadets, kung gusto mong maging Cardo Dalisay, magtumbling-tumbling ka pag may operations. Diba? We have the so-called special promotion. Okay? Ang special promotion, ito po yung sinasabi ko a while ago, na pwede ka po ma-exempt sa promotion board pag ginagawa yan, pag na-exempt ka by the chief of the PNP. Ganito ha, pag may medal of valor ka, when you say medal of valor, ito po yung award na binibigay sa mga tao na exhibited bravery, okay? Or nandiyan sa number 2, acts of conspicuous courage and gallantry at the risk of life over and beyond the call of duty. Nagka-siege, for example, yung Marawi siege, tapos you exhibit gallantry, bravery, hero ka, naging hero ka during the siege, and you were able to rescue a lot of ordinary citizens. Yan po yung gallantry mo, yung bravery mo, tapos nabigyan ka ng Medal of Valor, pwede po yan, ma-promote ka to a higher rank. Next, acts of outstanding leadership, ability, and efficiency in staff and supposed services over and above normal requirements. Criteria for regular promotion, na sobraan po yung mga achievements mo. Ha? Na sobraan, marami ka pong achievements in the past that give due credit to the Philippine National Police and contributed to the success of the mission and goals of the PNP. Ha? Over average yung contribution mo, pwede po, special promotion. Next, acts of high sense of moral value and honesty in the performance of duty or function. For example, patrolman ka, nakakuha ka ng or nakita mo yung foreigner, naiwan niya yung 5 million of pesos that was put inside a bag. That's an act of honesty. And that could be a good reason for you to have or to be benefited with the special promotion. Okay? Sir, what if ngayong taon, nagkagera and I exhibited gallantry? Promoted ka. By next year, nagkagera uli. Tapos, you showed gallantry. Another promotion, cadet. So, yan po. So, anyway, your life is very important. But I'm not saying that you have to go and be aggressive in your campaign against illegal elements. But when time is needed for you to be gallant or to be brave, then you have to exhibit such kind of characteristics kasi duty mo yan. But again, the reward, special promotion awaits for you. Next, yung pangatlo po, itong promotion by virtue of position. Ito. Any PNP personnel designated to any key position whose rank is lower than that which is required for such position shall after 6 months of occupying the same be entitled to a rank adjustment corresponding to the position. Let us say, for example, ginawa ka, let us say, ang rank mo lang is Brigadier General. Okay? Tapos you have been appointed by the President to become the Chief of the PNP. Yung rank ng chief is general, police general, right? Pero yung rank mo, brigadier general lang. Dapat po, within 6 months, you will be promoted to police general, considering that police general is the rank, ha? Yan po ang rank ko that is appropriate for the chief PNP. Okay? Pag provincial director ka lang, tapos ginawa kang regional director, dapat po, within 6 months po, there should be an adjustment of your rank equivalent to the rank of the regional director. Yan po ang sabi ng batas natin under promotion by virtue of position. I hope naintindihan po, kadet sa, I hope naintindihan. Now, sir, kailan po kami magre-retire? Dalawa po ang retirement nyo pag kayo naging police. Una, compulsory. Pangalawa, optional. Ang compulsory, whether you like it or not, yan nga, sinasabi dyan, compulsory kasi you are required. Pag 56 years old ka na, dapat you have to retire. Kasi yun lang po ang allowed na age. That is the age of retirement for compulsory. Pero kahit hindi ka pa nakaabot ng 56, nakaserve ka na ng 20 years of satisfactory active service. For example, 22 years old ka, naging police officer ka na. Plus 20, let us say 42 years old ka. Nakaserve ka, that's 20 years of service. So, pwede ka na pong mag-retire. You will avail for the optional retirement kahit hindi ka pa nakaabot ng 56 kasi nakaserve ka na ng 20 years satisfactory active service. Okay? So, yun po ang retirement natin. Now, punta tayo sa attrition. Ang ibig sabihin ng attrition, you got separated or you got removed from being a police officer. For short, na-eliminate ka from the organization. Nawala ka. Attrition, okay? Now, unahin natin itong attrition by attainment of a maximum tenure in position. Ang sabi ko kanina, ang tour of duty ng chief of PNP is 4 years. 4 years, ha? Aside from the chief PNP, may deputy chief PNP din tayo. Okay? Yung deputy chief of PNP, 4 din. Director of the staff services, 4 din. Yung regional director, dapat 6 years. Yung PD or city directors, dapat 9 years. Now, ano po ba ang mangyari? Unless earlier separated, retired, or promoted to a higher position in accordance with the PNP staffing pattern, police officers holding the above mentioned position shall be compulsory retired at the maximum tenure in position herein prescribed, or number 2, at the age of 56, whichever is earlier. Let us have an example. Let us say, naging chief PNP ka at the age of 50 pa lang. Yung retirement age natin, ha, 56. Pero naging chief PNP ka at the age of 50. Yung tour of duty mo, let us say, walang war, ha? Walang national emergencies. Wala. Wala yung dalawa. So, 4 lang. Hindi ba extend kasi walang war. Walang emergency. So, 4 na taon lang. 50 plus 4, naging 54 years old ka na. Kahit hindi ka pa nakaabot ng 56, ang sabi ng batas, dapat you will be retired na kasi ang tour of duty mo is 4 na taon lang. Nakuha nyo po? 4 na taon lang. Another example. Let us say, 53 years old ka, naging chief PNP ka. Okay? Yung tour of duty, again, 4. 53 plus 4, 57, right? Pero hindi pwede na mag-retire ka in 57. Kasi yung 57, lagpas na yan sa 56 eh. Lagpas na yan sa 56. Yung 57. So, when you When you reach 56, dapat naka-retire ka kahit hindi ka pa nakaabot ng 4 years tour of duty. Kasi ang sabi dyan, whichever is earlier. Mas early yung 56 kaysa sa ano eh, sa 57. So if you will render 4 years of duty, maging 57 ka. Hindi na yan allowed sa batas natin. Ang sabi, earlier. So dapat retire ka na ng 56 kahit hindi ka nakaabot ng 4 years tour of duty. I hope that is understandable. Same way, the Deputy Chief of PNP, the Director of Staff Services, Regional Director, PD and City Directors. Last example. Sir, PD ka, Provincial Director ka. Magna 9 years ka na next month, sir. Tapos, pag on the 9th year as PD, ang edad mo, sir, is ano pa lang? 50 years old pa lang. 41, nag-assume ka ng provincial director. Plus 9, naging 50 years old ka na, sir. So, ano ang gagawin? You will not be separated, you will not be considered as retired if you will be promoted to a higher position. So, for example, PD ka, ginawa kang regional director, hindi ka pwedeng ma-separate. And you will not be considered as retired either kasi you have been assigned to a higher position. Okay? I hope na intindihan po kada. Sir, what if yung chief of PNP i-assign sa higher position? No, because the highest is the chief of PNP. So hindi na po pwedeng ma-reassign to other higher position kasi yun na po ang highest. Pangalawa, attrition by relief. Okay? Now, a PNP uniform personnel who have been relieved. Okay? Ibig sabihin ng relieved, you have been out from your current position. For example, naging chief city COP ka. Tapos, may issue. Tapos, na-relieve ka. Na-relieve. Ibig sabihin ng na-relieve, you have been removed from your position as the COP of the city. Ang sabi dito, if you are not given an assignment within 2 years, naging floating ka na lang, you are not given an assignment within 2 years after such relief, dapat you will be considered as retired or either retired or separated. So pag sabi sa news, di ba, yung police chief was relieved from his post, meaning natanggal sa kanyang position. Pag hindi ka nabigyan ng position commensurate, when you say commensurate, equal to your rank within 2 years, pwede po, number one, maging mag-retire ka, number two, naging separated ka. Kahit hindi ka pa nakabot ng 56. Ha? Yan po ang problema sa attrition by relief. Pangatlo, attrition by demotion in position or rank. Any PNP personnel, civilian or uniform, who is relieved and assigned to a position lower than what is established for his or her grade in the PNP staffing pattern, and who shall not be assigned to a position commensurate to his or her grade within 18 months after such demotion in position, shall be retired or separated. Retired or separated po within 18 months. So, let's have an example para klarong-klaro po yung discussion natin. Let us say, yung rangko mo is Police Executive Master Sergeant. Tapos, due to an issue, na-demote ka. Let us say, you have been demoted to a lower rank. But in the demotion po, sa batas natin, especially sa labor code, kahit na-demote ka, yung salary mo will still remain the same. Ha? Will still remain the same, ha? Yung salary mo. Salary sa previous rank mo. Na-demote ka to a lower rank, yung salary mo sa previous rank will still remain. Now, within 18 months, pag hindi ka nabigyan ng position that is equal to your salary, to your grade, ha? Salary grade, pagka 18 po na buwan, 18 months, pwede ka pong you will be considered as retired or you will be separated from the service. So, yan po ang problema. So, dapat you will have to be reassigned. So, dapat hindi ka po, you should not do shenanigans while working. Next, attrition by non-promotion. Ito po, makasiparate po ito. Take note po sa mga, not just on magre-review, take note sa maging police dyan. Pag hindi ka na-promote for a continuous period of 10 years, 10 taon hindi ka na-promote, you will be considered as separated or retired. Kahit hindi ka pa nakaabot ng 56, retired ka or separated ka. Next, attrition by either means. Ito, PNP member or officer with at least 5 years of accumulated active service shall be separated based on the following factors. Dapat to, una, at least 5 taon kang nagsiservisyo bilang pulis. Pero, una, sa dalawang successive annual rating periods, ang rating mo is poor performance. Poor po yung rating mo. Pwede. Pangalawa, inefficiency based on poor performance for 3 cumulative annual rating periods. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng consecutive or successive tsaka yung cumulative? When we say successive, for example, may evaluation rating karon ngayon. May evaluation rating ngayon. Tapos, poor yung rating mo. Isa na yan. Sunod na taon, poor rating ka pa rin. Successive. Cumulative, ngayon, poor ang performance mo. The next year, naging satisfactory yung performance mo. The year after next year, bumalik ka naman sa poor performance. Dalawa na. Cumulative na yan. The second year, the next year, naging satisfactory ka uli. Then, after that year, naging poor ka naman. Tatlong cumulative, pwede po yan. Ground for attrition. Next, physical or mental incapacity. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng physical? For example, naging handicapped ka na. Pwede po, attrition. Pangalawa, mental incapacity. Medyo nag-suffer po tayo ng schizophrenia or you are suffering on a disease like delusion or illusion or hallucination. So, di na po pwede. You will be subject for attrition. You will have to be separated. Okay? So, yun po ha. Dapat take note po natin yan, kadetsa. So, ang techniques lang po dyan, yung mga techniques natin on how to be promoted, dapat you should, number one, do your job properly. Number two, document everything that you do. For example, like maybe you are doing a clean-up drive with these organizations in the PNP, dapat po documented yan kasi magamit yan sa report mo. Pangatlo po, which is very important sa magpupulis dyan, take master's degree, please. Take master's degree, whether it is a Master of Science in Public Administration or Master of Science in Criminal Justice, I do not care. But just take master's degree or you take Bachelor of Law. Try to amplify your knowledge by going back to school again. Kasi makakatulong po yan. Now, lastly, I will talk about police managerial activities and roles. Ito, plus na po to ha. May tatlo po yan. Interpersonal, informational, tsaka yung decision roles ng PNP. Una, interpersonal role po. Kung interpersonal, ibig sabihin yan yung establishment ng relationship natin with other people. Figurehead, hosting and attending official ceremonies. For example, there is a opening of a festival. Interpersonal po yon, yung nag-attend ka. Leadership, yung you create motivation and enthusiasm and serving people's needs. Liaison, ibig sabihin ng liaison po, ikaw po yung middleman. You maintain contacts with important people and groups. Ikaw yung middleman, for example, you spread the news or you spread the instructions from the Philippine National Police to other individuals or to other organizations. Next, informational roles. It talks about the exchanging of information. Number one, monitor, seeking out relevant information. Disseminator, yung nag-share ka ng information with insiders. Pwede din pong spokesperson, you share information with the outsiders. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng disseminator at spokesperson? Ibig sabihin ng disseminator, ibig sabihin dyan, for example, naging regular guest ng radio frequency or ng radio outlet. Tapos every Sunday, you disseminate about awareness on drugs. Pwede po. Spokesperson, ito po yung taong that will represent a Philippine National Police who will speak on behalf of the Philippine National Police. Okay? Next, decision roles. Number one, entrepreneur. Seeking problems to solve and opportunities to explore. Disturbance handler, helping to resolve conflicts. resource allocator, allocating resources to various uses, and negotiator, negotiating with other parties. Ito po ang mga managerial activities and roles sa Philippine National Police. I hope you understand, cadets, sa second discussion natin, second episode po. Maraming salamat po. Mayroon pa po tayong third episode. Yan na po ang last, okay? We'll be talking about other law enforcement agencies in the last episode. I hope you will bear with me. I hope you will bear with me. And I hope I was able to give justice of your time, was able to amplify your knowledge so that you can utilize it in the upcoming criminology licensure examination. Maraming salamat po. God bless you and stay safe.